On the third at break of dawn, the sun arose.
I turned to heaven and spoke your name.
last one on the list. I'm not a pro professor. Here's the deal. When we get to the end of a program, we want to keep singing. I don't know how many people you know that feel that way, but I hope you do. When you've finished a song, it never ends. It just keeps on going because you sing through your life. That's what you want to do. You want to sing. And so they don't want to get off the stage. And it's not because they're a bunch of hot dogs, although they are. What they really want to do is keep on praising the Lord. And that's what they're going to do. That's what they're going to keep on doing for the rest of their life. Because they made a choice. They chose Jesus. The last song we're going to sing is called Great Yet No More. And we sing it because, well, it says it all. And you get to the end, hallelujah. And that's really, that's what we're doing. We're walking toward that great yet. So, thank you so much. Kenny and Melissa fed us like you wouldn't believe this week. I mean, I went to bed last night and my stomach said, hey, what did you just do? And it was like, well, I ate too much. That was the answer. Boy, that's good. Man, that pork loin, goodness. Anyway, they came up from Harrison all the way just to see me. I don't know if Lane had anything to do with it, or maybe grandkids, or even Logan, I don't know. Anyway, the joy they have brought is beautiful, and I appreciate them doing that. You guys, through the people of this church, when we got there, when I drove the bus up here yesterday, there was Lane, and there was Krista. And they could hardly wait for the door to open before they started welcoming us. Are y'all like that? Is that the way this whole church is? Man, that is so beautiful. Thank you. We felt so welcome, and now we're so full. We won't get much of a chance to say we got to pack up real quick, and we're going to stay through part of second service, and then we're going to hit the road because, oddly enough, these young people have other things this evening that are equally as important to them as well as riding down on the bus with me. So, we will be packing up rather quickly, so if you see us frenetically trying to get something done and you're standing in the aisle and somebody says, excuse me, and they're pushing a cart, I'll just let them by. It'd be okay. Make things go faster. You guys want to say anything? Are we good? Okay. They haven't talked a lot, have they? Luckily, they have a director that can't shut up, so it's okay.
Do you want us to talk?
What? No, I really don't. What? Sure you do. Lane was in the group 10 years ago. That means she's 71. I was very young at that age, and directing was still new to me. But she is, I think one of the last shows we did was in Harrison, and one of the last songs we sang was, I believe, in a hill called Mount Calvary, and I sang it with the favorite person who I ever sang it with in my life, and I've never sung it with another person, and that was Lane. So, yeah, we both cried, it was okay. Anyway, let's sing this song, get off stage, and act like we have some sense about ourselves. Anyway. Thank you so much, Pastor.
I'm going to tell you about the coming of the judgment.
Very well.
I'm going to tell you about the coming of the judgment.
Very well.
There's a better day of coming.
Very well.
There's a better day of coming.
Very well.
In that great
kingdom.
When you hear the thunder crashing,
very well, very well. see the stars are falling.
Fairly well, fairly well.
When you hear the chariots calling.
Fairly well, fairly well.
In that
great hidden up morning. Fairly well, fairly well.
In that
great hidden up morning. Fairly well, fairly well.
When you see the lightning flashing, when you hear the thunder crashing, when you see